Hey guys, my name is Tzachi and welcome to my channel. For you newcomers, I have been an Apple collector for more than 15 years. And in my channel, you will find reviews of new and vintage Apple products. So, if you are a collector or just Apple freaks, my channel is definitely your home. In today's video, we will go 20 years back to one of Steve Jobs' revolutions in the music field. Just before I begin, if you still haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe now. That way you will receive updates about future videos. I really appreciate it. I brought the second generation iPod from my private collection with its box from 2002, including its original accessories, which are all inside new and sealed. Today, it's very hard to find this iPod for sale in this condition. And if there are any to be found, the prices range between $4,000 to $6,000. It's a lot of money considering all the previous generation have been sold between $299 to $499. If you decide to purchase a used iPod, one of the most important things you should look out for is that both the box and the iPod have the same serial number. Apple has produced 6 generations of this model. When the first was announced in 2001 and had 5 giga, which translate into 1000 songs, whereas the last model in 2007 had 160 giga, which translate into 32,000 songs. Apple renamed the last generation iPod and added the word classics. And now let's open the box and see how everything is packed so beautifully as only Apple knows how. Wow. On the right side, we have the iPod itself. But first, let's open the envelope and see what we have inside. In its envelope, we have the disc, and also we have inside the box all the other accessories, such as the charger, remote control, leather cover. Here we have the original headphones and firmware cable. As of 2021, the only model which is left from all the iPod model is the iPod Touch. And let me add, it's already boring. We all know that there is no real meaning to iPods today. I don't see anyone walking around with both an iPhone and iPod just to listen to music, and even more so for those who have an Apple Watch. In my opinion, Apple will not take the iPod off the market because this is one of their most powerful and biggest icons. And even more so because this is a Steve Jobs product. But for it to survive, they will need to reinvent it, giving it a new name, features, and new design. And we all know that Apple is capable. I am really interested to know what you think about iPod's future. Let me know in the comments below. Guys, that's all for this video. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel. For any questions regarding this video, you are welcome to ask. Thanks for watching and looking forward to seeing you in my next video.